special conversation. Wish you all a very happy Women's Day. We've decided to use this day, to use this occasion, to have some conversations that more often than not don't make headlines, don't make it to the front of a news channel, at least not on a regular basis. And so through today, through Women's Day, we are going to be having conversation with various women heroes of our country, of our world. And we will be talking to them about various changes that we need to bring in for gender equality. India's women are marching shoulder to shoulder with men, often surpassing them in several disciplines. So as we celebrate Women's Day, right now we've put together a panel of sports stars who inspire not just people of our nation, but people, women especially, across the world. And the question that I want to ask all of them is, are sports as a segment something where we can look at equal pay for women and men? Why should there not be equal pay for women sports stars? Is India really doing enough for women sporting stars? Are women in sports still a taboo for families? Why are more people not watching sports and women's sports? Is that a reason that we don't have pay parity? We're talking about pay parity in almost every segment. Why should it be different for our sports stars? Let's welcome our special guests who are joining us on this conversation. I've got Syeda Falak, karate champion. She's the international karate champion known as the Golden Girl of Hyderabad. Learned karate at the age of 12. Represented India at World Karate Premier League. I've also got Trupti Murgunde, badminton player, who's joining us right now. She's a gold medalist at the South Asian Games. So she's an ace shuttler who's right now joining us from Pune. And Jaya Sharma, former cricketer, represented India in 77 ODIs, represented us and our country in T20 and Test matches, former BCCI Player of the Year. I'll also have Suma, Shirur, a very renowned shooter, joining us shortly. But let's begin with Jaya Sharma. And Jaya Sharma, you know, especially for a sport like cricket that is loved so much in our country and followed so much in our country, what's the extent of difference in what women and men cricketers earn in our country?
Well, I would like to start this conversation putting forward some facts. When we started playing, like in our era, there was nothing. No monetary benefit, nothing was there. But after BCCI took over, the things were much better, much better. But yes, if you talk about pay parity, I think we have a long way to go.
So there are different avenues, Jaya. You know, for a cricketer, you have sponsorships, you have the money that the BCCI is bringing in. There are different tournaments that you're playing. Then there's the prize money. Is there a disparity at all levels even now? How far away are we from being on the same level? And do you think that's even a real possibility?
Well, This time for the T20 World Cup, the ICC has put a good prize money for the tournament. So this is something which ICC has taken a step towards. And if I talk about the pay with respect to men, yes, it is, you know, when you compare both, it's very nominal, you can say. Mm-hmm. But I think when there was nothing, It is much better. At least now players can devote, you know, time, training and spending on themselves, playing on a good cricket grounds, and they can afford to hire trainers, coaches right now. So if you talk about cricket, yes, it is improving, definitely. But I'm saying there is a long way to go.
Mm-hmm. So, it's also sort of a chicken and egg situation where if you're not given enough support, if you're not given enough infrastructure, or if you're not given enough training and equipment, then you're not going to be able to perform as well. And if you don't perform and you don't get the recognition and you don't get the awards, perhaps enough people will not watch you. Perhaps enough money will not come in. And that's how the whole cycle goes. Trupti Murgunde, So where do we start fixing this? Is it to say, let's first support the women athletes and the women, you know, sports stars, give them what they need, and once they start performing, then everything else will automatically fall in place, the commercial angle will fall in place?
If I have to talk about my sport, as she said, you know, when I was playing, there was definitely a pay disparity, in those days where the men were getting definitely about 20 to 30% more than what the women would get. But over a period of time, right now, if we see, we have an equal pay, or rather, I would say, put it as the prize money is equally paid. So there have been a lot of changes, in the earlier times, in probably when I was in juniors, then the even the point system was totally different. You know, the men had to play a 15-point best of three game, whereas the women would play about 11 points best of three. Then eventually, even in the draws, there was a difference. You know, the men draw would be a bigger draw compared to the women draw. So they would say, okay, the men are playing much more rounds of the matches. So that's how they are paid slightly more compared to the women. But now the things are different. Now we have a equal point system as well, which is the 21 points best of three. So, and also the draw is equal. So the pay, the prize money is paid equally. And so in my sport, as of now, the things are quite good, I would say. Talking about, with respect to the endorsements and things like that, I think if I have to talk about the Indian badminton, I think the women are doing fabulously. I think if you see, PV Sindhu is one of the highest paid right now.
Mm-hmm. And if I had to ask you what brought about this change, from the time that you were speaking about when there was absolutely, such a huge gap between the two, and now you're all on the same, almost at the same level, is it because, the minute you start delivering on winning medals and getting that kind of recognition that everything else comes together, what brought about this change, Trupti?
Like I said earlier, we had a difference in the point system. And as I said, even the number of rounds which were played probably were more for the men. So that is one of the aspects. And as you also said, the women were also doing good. In badminton, we have had fairly a few women who have been doing very well. In fact, and now it's one of the priority sport in the country. So that also at the same time brings those changes. So even at, if I have to talk, even at the international level, where the BWF has actually got this rule, and then eventually it was brought in India as well. So I think it's just that, the number of women players compared to the days when I was playing has increased now, and it's getting more better now.
So one thing, of course, that has changed is that more women are playing, more women are actually getting the recognition, are delivering and pretty much performing, like their male counterparts. And the other, like Trupti was pointing out, specific to badminton, is that the point system has become pretty much pretty similar. And that's often the argument given in such sports, whether it's badminton or even in tennis, where they say, oh, men play more matches, and which is why their game goes on for longer, which is perhaps why they get paid more, because people are watching it for a longer time and women don't. That was one of the arguments that's also given for tennis. You've had even the biggest of the stars across the world, from Venus and Serena, talk about, pay parity and gender pay parity, to our stars in cricket as well, and Mithali Raj, who's also spoken out about it. Syeda, Falak, what's your own sense? The change is taking place gradually, but will we ever actually get to a point where across sports we see this kind of pay equality?
Pay disparity comes when there is less participation among the women categories and if there is less audience for the women events. When it comes to my sport, karate, for World Karate Premier League Series A, we are paid equally compared to men. And yeah, but in some open championships, if there is an open category, like in the category in which athletes from all weight categories can participate, it's like an open challenge. So for that, for men's category, there'll be more of participation and the, you know, the audience will be cheering. So in some open championships, yes, we have more prize money for the open categories for men when compared to women. So I think it depends upon the participation and how many of the audience watch it.
So how do you bring about that change in karate side, that you know more, that people start watching it more? Do you believe that perhaps media has a larger role to play, or is it the federations themselves, brands who perhaps don't focus so much on you know, sports and arts like karate?
When it comes to the world level, of course, the prize money is same. But when it comes to India or some open championships, there's a difference. So I think more girls should come up and participate. Because, of course, women or girls taking up taking part in combat sports like karate, martial arts, that is very much attractive. And the audience will be pleased to watch it. But encouragement should be given to girls, and more girls should come up and take up the sport.
That's an interesting point that you're making. Suma, Shirur, thank you for joining us as well. Do you think, you know, as more and more women start participating across sports, their families are more supportive, we have federations, you know, who are more supportive, who don't treat the women, you know, the sportswomen like a stepchild in comparison to the sportsmen? Perhaps that's where we need to bring about a change, and that's how things will move.
I think pay parity comes with gender equality, and I think the whole world is moving towards gender equality, and the same goes to sport, and even the Olympic movement. I think they are slowly moving towards gender equality, and if I can talk about my sport in shooting, they've really cut down on many men events. You know, in previous times, men always had more events than the women. They always shot more shots than the women. So I think over the years, the whole Olympic movement is also moving towards gender equality. And in shooting, they've really cut down on the men events. So now women and men shoot equal number of events. And they've also made equal number of shots. Like in previous times, women had 40 shots, men had 60 shots. But now it's no longer, it's the same for both. So I think it's really about the participation is one aspect. Yes, we want more and more women, but even apart from that, I think it's a movement moving in the right direction, I would say, as a woman.
What more can be done? Say, let's take Olympics for example, or let's just take shooting for example. There was a period where in our country, suddenly this segment got a lot of attention. Players were doing really well, shooters were doing really well, they were winning accolades everywhere. And I think that's where perhaps the change for this sport really came through. Is that what it is? Then simply that recognition and getting the attention would then have more people talking about it?
Definitely, that's part of the story. When we started shooting 25 years ago, we really only had about 6 or 7 women participants in my event, which was, there was absolutely no equation when it comes to, you know, at least hundreds of men in the event. So I think over time, we have more and more women participating. And as far as our sport is concerned, really, there's never been a question of having different pay scales or they're having different prize money. It's never ever been the case. So even when we were shooting lesser number of events, even when we had lesser shots that we shot, even then we had pay parity. So it's about, I think, different sport having different ways in which the federation take them. But I think as far as India is concerned also, I think we are across not just sport, you know, across all careers, we are moving towards gender parity. Like now if you look at, say, the Supreme Court ruling that even in the armed forces you have... women will be given combat roles and they will be given, commission. So I think the whole movement is moving towards that, which is which is good for us.
So in shooting, you know, is one example that we got where you've seen pay parity. Of course, larger representation of women, more events for women shooters is what we are moving towards, and that's where the gender equality comes in. In badminton, things have improved. But Jaya, in cricket, we're still talking about it. The top, you know, even the current cricketing team and the top players in our current cricket team who are doing so well right now are still talking about, you know, getting that kind of a parity. There are many who say that it won't come anytime soon because not enough people are watching women cricket. And if not enough people are watching women cricket, not enough people are talking about these, you know, cricketers and are interested in what they are doing and how much, you know, how great they are playing, then the ads are not going to come, then the sponsorship won't come, then the money won't come. And so it's pure, simple, you know, commercial math. It's not to say we don't want to pay you more, but it's just commercial math. What would you say to that argument?
Well, it's basically that, you know, you have to understand that it's basically a business for people. We are playing, right, but not everyone is playing. People, the companies are there who are investing their money, who want their ROI to be better, you know. So if we talk about the men cricket team, what changed the scenario for the men cricket team also was the Kapil Dev and the company won 1983's World Cup. So that was the key moment. And from there, the men cricket changed and money came into cricket. So that's what I think our girls should do, which we are very close of now that we have entered into the T20 finals. We are very close. So there's a responsibility of both the parties, let's say the federation and the team. They both have to come with performance. And if we will be able to win the championship, I think then BCCI will definitely support women team, as the talks are already being going on about the IPL for women's. So I think it's basically because I am a management student, so I can understand that there is a part that ROI plays a very bigger role. Again, your fan base plays a very bigger role in endorsements, in spectators. So, of course, the more you will show, the media will show a women player on TV, the more people will get to know about it. So I can see the change which we have not earlier witnessed. I can see the change in women cricket team popularity now that people are witnessing the game. And they know that our women team are doing really well. I can say this because in 2005, I was the part of the team which was World Cup runners-up. Yes. And till the time we got into the semi-finals and won, beating defending champions New Zealand, nobody was aware back home that we are playing a World Cup. So I think now that it's coming on the TV now, so it's both ways. If we win, we will definitely get endorsements, and people will love to watch us.
How did you manage then, Jaya? How did the, you know, women cricketers at that time, you know, reach those levels with the lack of attention, the lack of support that you had in that era? You know, tell us a little bit more about that. How did you all manage?
I think it was just the love for the game and love for the sports that our era, you know, just survived. And you won't believe that we used to stay in dormitories, eat roadside food. There were not good grounds to play on. All these things have been changed now. Even if you are playing for a state side, you are put up in a 4-star hotel. You have been given a flight ticket. And we used to travel with no reservation in third class compartments, sitting near the toilets. So I think it was just, I think it was just the love for the game. And we didn't know anything other than that. So we just went on and tried and build good future for the next generation to come.
You know, and when you were saying that, and when you were talking about the kind of food that you all were eating, the kind of grounds that you were training on, I could see the other ladies on the panel also knowingly nod and smile. You know, it's perhaps what irrespective of what sport you are in, you know, you go through. Trupti, do you want to add to what Jaya was saying there from your own experiences?
Yes, I mean, I totally agree with her. You know, even we've had these kind of stays earlier, staying in the dormitories and, you know, the food quality and things like that. But, you know, things have changed now. Now, in those days, I would say sports was not considered as one of the main careers. You know, it was like given the second priority. Education was first. So things have changed now. We are having a sporting trend which we clearly can see in India last few years. And so eventually everything is changing. You know, I can say that cricket was still is highly rated sport, highly paid sport compared to the other sports. But nevertheless, things have changed. I would say, if I have to talk about badminton, probably, you know, the win coming after Pulela Gopichand won the All England, then he coming into coaching, and then Saina Nehwal doing well. A lot of endorsements, apart from the sports kitting, we started seeing coming into badminton. And then eventually, you know, we have few sports persons, PV Sindhu. And even in the men, you know, the endorsements started there on after with different brands. So we have seen a drastic change. And with the same thing, you know, as the sport gets popular, everything else around it also changes. So then your stay, your comfort levels, you know, the professionalism starts much more and becomes much more evident.
Mm. Well, so that's as far as badminton is concerned. Suma, do you want to add to that from your own experiences from the shooting world? How different is it? How at every stage, you know, there are often conversations in general in our lives about equality and how some women have it more difficult than the men do in the same field.
Definitely, I would say for all of us, passion has always been the, you know, overriding reason why we are all still into it. Mm-hmm. And of course, I'm happy to be part of the change that the shooting scenario is today, where things are really much, much better. It's a lot more professional. But apart from that, I do believe that, yes, women have a lot of challenges coming their way, especially, you know, with all the biological changes and all the responsibilities that a woman has to cater to. It's definitely a lot more challenging to survive in a sport over time. But at the same time, you know, going through all the conversations that we've been into, irrespective of all the, you know, of all the viewership reasons, irrespective of the number of participation that women have, irrespective of all these things, I feel that it is the onus and the responsibility of the world body of the federation to ensure that you know, there is pay parity. Mm. And I would definitely cite the example of ISSF, the International Shooting Sport Federation, which cut down on one of the most popular events, the 50 meter rifle prone event for men. It was one of the, you know, one event where it had maximum participation around the world, but it was only men. But despite being one of the most popular events, ISSF definitely cut down on that event just to make it, you know, just for the gender equality. So I think hats off to them for the vision and for their commitment towards gender equality. And I think this is something that a lot of other federations should take note and step on that line, irrespective of the number of participation of the women, or, you know, there could be 100 reasons why there shouldn't be. But I think this is one reason
was it at some commercial cost?
The world must move ahead.
Suma, when they cut it down, when they did away with that event,
100%.
Was there a commercial cost to the federation, to the authorities? Because that would be the biggest challenge, right? How do you tell any federation or administration that don't make money where you can, but do something which is more to, you know, put men and women at the same platform?
Definitely, there was it was at a cost, because you know, if you cut down on one Olympic event, naturally the participation at every level goes down. So the number of guns being purchased goes down, the number of ammunition used. So there were a lot of gun companies, the factories, the companies that were shouting against it. The whole shooting fraternity really, really, you know, that was one time when I would say the shooting fraternity was divided. But I think ISS have just stood ground and they said, no, this is the way we are headed. So I would say I really, really appreciate them, and I salute them for this really bold decision. It definitely came at a cost.
Okay, so well, that's an interesting example, and I think that's an inspirational example that perhaps we need to see in more different kinds of sports to help bring about a change. Syeda, your choice, you know, karate itself is very different. You while we all, you know, in our younger days, perhaps did try our hand at, you know, any kind of martial art. You went ahead and decided to make a career out of it. Were there a lot of women? Were there a lot of girls at that point, you know, who were also doing the same? How was the experience for you at that time?
I started learning karate 13 years back, and that time the mentality of the people was like, karate is a man sport. If you learn it, you'll become manly. And I was criticized by a few people, few relatives or friends, that I would become manly. I should not go into such sport. But from then and now, there's a lot of difference, especially in my state. I can see that a lot of girls have been inspired by me and has taken up the sport. And people now have a different perspective of the sport, karate, martial arts. And yes, if it also helps in self-defense. So self-defense is trending nowadays, and many people are interested to learn the sport and also learn self-defense. So the perspective 13 years back, the perspective of the people, and now there's a lot of difference.
And you know, in terms of supporting the sport, in terms of supporting the art, and bringing more people on board, is you know, what is it that will be required and can be done?
More and more awareness should be there about such sports, and encouragement should be given, and recognition should be given to karate athletes as well. Equal attention and financial assistance should be given, and there should be a clear picture that karate is not just a man's sport, or martial arts is not only for men. It is equally important for men, and it is more important for girls to learn to be in such sports, because it makes you very strong and confident.
Yeah, no. So, for example, in any family, if you had to sell this idea, the response from any from parents would be, "You can't make a career out of it. You can't. How long can you sustain? How much money will you make? Who's going to be watching you? What are you going to be winning? What is the point of it? It's not just, you know, your passion is not going to take you anywhere." When such questions are asked, what do you tell them?
Yeah, that mindset should be changed. Of course, when I told my parents that I wanted to learn karate, they were a bit shocked, like, why karate? It's a man's sport. But they had supported me, and because of them, I have come up till here. So parents should encourage, the mindset of the society, the mindset of the parents should be changed, because of course we face many difficulties, but when a particular person or someone comes up in the sport and win at a bigger level, like world championship or something, and if they become famous, then definitely the rest will follow, and more champions will be produced from any sport. So in my state, I can say that when I have come up at international level, in my state, at least many girls have taken up this sport. But the thing is, if someone comes up at the national level, if they become famous at the national level and win world championships or something like that, then definitely more awareness will be there all over India. And many girls will be inspired to take up such sports.
Okay, I completely agree with you, and I think, you know, the more you have faces, but like we saw, you know, even in tennis or in badminton, the more people will start talking about it, you know, and the more then there is awareness about it and people open up to the idea of, all right, perhaps you can pursue this. Trupti, you know, was it difficult for you to convince your family at that point of time that, no, this is what I want to do, badminton, that's it?
Well, I had a little different story, you know, when I started at the age of 9, and by 10 I was a state champion, and I had to travel within the state to play my tournaments. And my grandfather came a little bit from the orthodox thinking, and he said, no, a girl child probably cannot go out and play a sport. You know, sport was, as I said, you know, sport was more considered as more of a recreation or something like that, and not as a career. But then my mother has been a sports person herself, and she encouraged me. My father also supported me, and my brother, my sister. So they all supported me, and there was a point when we actually sneaked out of the house to play a tournament. And my grandfather gets to know the next morning when it comes in the newspaper. you know, the heading was with my name, and he was surprised. And then everybody at home had a very bad time. But then what happened was, eventually his friends started asking him, you know, who is Murgunde with my surname, you know, Murgunde. And then he started telling, she's my granddaughter. And they started appreciating. And he started liking that, you know, that, you know, the society is accepting this fact and everybody is appreciating. And he was feeling good about it. And then, in fact, there was a point when he started coming to watch my matches. So that was... As I said, you know, it's just the mindset that entirely changed. And when he got to know that the society is accepting it, so he was open for it. So that is one thing. And just to add on the thing that how do you, the question what you put up earlier, saying that how do you sell? I would say that, you know, now there are a lot of opportunities in sports. You can make sports as a sole career. I am with the Indian Oil Company. I joined the Indian Oil Company as a sports recruitment. It's been nearly 16 years for me. That time it was only recruitment, but whereas now we've got scholarships, we've got tenure basis. So a lot more sports persons can get into these kind of companies, PSUs, and a lot of such opportunities are there. So you can make sports as a career also. And at the same time, a lot of different avenues have opened up, like sports management, sports medicine, you know, all these kind of things have opened up. So there is definitely a future, you know, where you are starting as a sports person. So I think this will give a lot of confidence to the parents as well when they want to put their child or support them or, you know, encourage them to continue with sports.
Jaya, do you want to add to that, you know, what happens beyond a certain age when active playing is not an option anymore, especially for women, then what's next?
Yeah, that's exactly, you know, my point was when I said, you know,
Shruti, I'll just take that question to Jaya Sharma also.
Long time now.
Yes, yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think just now Trupti mentioned that, you know, there are many avenues now. So for as a parent, I would like my child, if in any field, to be employed. So that is one thing that a parent wants. So I think on that front, I also struggled a bit with my family. Not exactly my family, but my father, because he wanted me to study. So, because there was nothing going around, like, we'll get something. There was no money. There was no nothing. So, of course, he wanted me to go into academic side, but my mother supported me a lot. So, this is something which is very valid for parents, that it's now that the women sports is being watched. The sponsorships are coming. So the companies are there, like the PSUs, and I even am employed with railways. So in women's cricket, though, the picture is a bit different. Indian Railways is the only institution which provides job to women cricketers. So if you talk about the Indian team, you will find 70 to 80% people, players from Indian Railways itself, mm-hmm. from different railways. So yes, as a career, you need to see an option. But that is being changed now in women's cricket specifically, because as I told you, the state player is also earning now. A 14-year-old, I was with the DDC as a selector for 3 years, and a 14-year-old girl was playing all the tournaments, and she could easily made, I think, 70 to 80K in one season.
Right. Right. So, I just want to also read out some of the ladies who've spoken up in the past several years and have been part of the change, just like our panelists, in bringing about this change that we're now seeing, where at least in some sports, you're beginning to see a lot more recognition for the, sportswomen. You're beginning to see a lot more support, infrastructure being given, even pay parity. But there was a time when even Sania Mirza felt the need to say, I have been saying for long that women should be paid equal prize money with men, that this discrimination is in all sports worldwide. My question is, why we even need to explain that women should have equal prize money with men? I want to reach that day that we don't need to explain it. There was a time when even Pulela Gopichand and Trupti was just referring to what he did and the kind of change he brought about to the sport. There was a time when he said that the reality talent is available all over India, but we actually need a system and we need more cash inflow. And you can see with the efforts that are now being put in various training academies when it comes to badminton and the kind of change that's brought about in badminton. But in hockey, in football, in cricket, there is so much more that can still be done. Suma, there is so much more that we can only do once there is awareness that if you don't push and give the platform, you will never be able to recognize the true potential. And there may be so many more women out there who could perhaps do much better than their male counterparts at these sports.
Yeah, exactly. That is what I feel, that why should we give any explanation? It's there should not be any reason why we should be giving for gender equality or pay parity. And I think more and more women need to speak up, and it's very disheartening to know that even in today's times, we do have certain sport where I think those sports where you have viewership issues, where you have this pay parity. But I think more and more people need to speak against it. And like I said, it's really the responsibility of people running the show, of heads of federations and the world body to drive this point.
Right.
And I definitely feel women should speak up. And I think gender equality begins at home. So I think more and more parents need to make their children aware. And luckily for me, I must thank my parents. They never made me feel like a woman. It was always an individual. So even now, I speak as an individual. And I think this is one trait that we need to dig into our society, so that more and more women have the courage to speak and believe that, they should be treated at par as the men.
Absolutely. Yes, absolutely. In fact, I would go on to say that if you look at the story of any successful woman in whichever field it is, from sports to any other industry, it will probably be starting from the fact, of course, that she had a family and she had parents who didn't see her just as a woman, but she saw her as an individual and said, no, we are going to support you. And I think we think that the choice that you're making is perfectly fine, and you should go all out and, follow what you want to do in life and follow it with all the passion that you have. So women are out there who have that passion, who have the will. It's only for the rest of the world to actually understand that we need to just give them the way, give them the path to build these dreams. That's all there is to it. Thank you so much to all of you lovely ladies for joining us. Thank you so much for what you've done in your own fields of sports and bringing us all of those accolades. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. Now, these are not the only sports where, we've seen changes come in, but a lot more has to be done. I was referring to hockey. Again, a sport, and just like cricket, even after they're done playing, it's not as if the country is very good at looking after our hockey stars. They don't get jobs. Perhaps railways is still the only one that actually employs former hockey players, just like cricket. And that has to change. If the male cricketers and the male hockey players and footballers are given so much recognition and so much money and so much of support, why should it be any different for women? Let's have a conversation. I had a conversation with India's queen of hockey, Rani Rampal. And I actually began by asking her, obviously, about the year that she's been having. She's had a great year. She was given the Padma Award. She's won so many accolades already in the first couple of months. So I asked her that if she's also hoping to end her year with a similar bang at the Olympics. And this is what she said.
हाँ जी बिल्कुल 2020 की जो स्टार्टिंग है वो काफ़ी अच्छी हुई थी कि काफ़ी सारे अवार्ड्स जो हैं वो मिले लेकिन आई थिंक द बिगेस्ट अवार्ड विल बी कि जब हम ओलंपिक्स में अच्छा करेंगे कंट्री के लिए एंड हमारी पूरी टीम का एक वही मिशन है कि हमें ओलंपिक्स में अच्छा करना है अपनी कंट्री के लिए और वहाँ पर मेडल जीतना है
और आपको इतने अवार्ड्स अब मिल रहे हैं रानी जी और आप यू नो इतना रिकग्निशन मिल रहा है क्या इससे बदलाव आता है इससे क्या इम्पैक्ट हुआ है आपकी लाइफ में आपके करियर में
अभी देखा जाए तो अभी वुमेन्स को काफ़ी ज़्यादा रिकग्निशन मिलने लगी है हमारी कंट्री में जो पहले इतनी ज़्यादा नहीं मिलती थी एंड स्पेशली जब से बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ हमारी गवर्नमेंट ने शुरू किया एंड हमारी वुमेन्स के एफर्ट्स को रिकॉग्नाइज़ किया जाता है एंड वुमेन्स स्पेशली नॉट ओनली इन स्पोर्ट्स लेकिन सभी फील्ड्स में काफ़ी अच्छा कर रही हैं और जो बाकी वुमेन्स हैं उनके लिए एक अच्छी इंस्पिरेशन बन रही हैं सो काफ़ी बदलाव आया है पहले से हमारी कंट्री में वुमेन्स को लेके एंड स्पेशली आजकल अगर देखा जाए तो सिर्फ ऐसा नहीं सोचा था कि वुमेन सिर्फ एक यू नो घर के काम के लिए रखी जाती हैं दे आर लाइक कि उनको घर से बाहर जाना है उनको अपने ड्रीम्स जो वो पूरा करना चाहते हैं वो कर सकते हैं फैमिलीज आजकल काफ़ी सपोर्टिव हो गई है पेरेंट्स काफ़ी सपोर्टिव हो गए हैं आजकल एंड स्पेशली द गवर्नमेंट की हमें वुमेंस के लिए आजकल काफ़ी सारी स्कीम्स जो शुरू की हुई हैं उससे वुमेंस को काफ़ी ज़्यादा कॉन्फिडेंस आता है एक मोटिवेशन मिलती है कि आप कंट्री में जो है एक इक्वलिटी लेके आ रहे हो
हम ये वुमेंस डे के अवसर पे पैरिटी के बारे में भी बात कर रहे हैं कि कैसे जो मेन और वुमेन हैं स्पोर्ट्स में उनको पे पैरिटी नहीं है मेल्स को बहुत ज़्यादा मिलता है काफ़ी स्पोर्ट्स स्टार्स और एथलीट्स ने इसके बारे में बात भी किया है आपका क्या क्या व्यू है इसमें कि कैसे ये बदलाव आए
आई थिंक वुमेंस के लिए हमारी कंट्री में जितना इक्वालिटी आएगा उतना ज़्यादा अच्छा है एंड अगर हम वुमेंस को और ज़्यादा इम्पावर करेंगे तो उतना ज़्यादा हमारी कंट्री हमारी सोसाइटी उतनी ज़्यादा डेवलप होगी एंड जब तक हम वुमेंस को इम्पावर नहीं करेंगे वुमेंस को उतना सपोर्ट नहीं करेंगे या उनको स्पेशली मनी वाइज उनको इतना इक्वालिटी नहीं देंगे देन कहीं ना कहीं हम यू नो एज अ सोसाइटी एज अ कंट्री हम लोग डाउन जाते हैं सो आई थिंक बहुत ज़रूरी है कि वुमेंस को भी वो सब चीज़ें प्रोवाइड होनी चाहिए जो मेंस को होती हैं एंड बिकॉज आई थिंक वुमेंस कैन डू मच बेटर देन द मेंस अगर हम सब मिलके उनमें बिलीव करना शुरू करेंगे कि हमें वुमेंस को सपोर्ट करना है एंड उनके ड्रीम्स पूरे करने के लिए उनको हेल्प करनी है
आपको पूरा कॉन्फिडेंस है कि आपकी टीम जो वुमेन टीम है वो मेन को आउट परफॉर्म करेगी एंड होपफुली उससे बेटर रिटर्न्स मिलेंगे वुमेन प्लेयर्स के लिए
नहीं डेफिनेटली हमारी टीम काफ़ी अच्छा कर रही है काफ़ी सालों से एंड हम लोग इसका एंड भी ऐसे ही करना चाहते हैं कि हम लोग इन्हें एक हाई अच्छी परफॉर्मेंस दे के एंड कंट्री के लिए मैक्सिमम मेडल जीतें एंड डेफिनेटली जब हम मेडल जीते हैं तो ऑफकोर्स हमारी गवर्नमेंट फेडरेशन हमें ज़रूर हेल्प करती है हमें वो हमारा जो क्या बोलते हैं एक मोटिवेशन हमें चाहिए या जो भी हमारा उस चीज़ के लिए हमें रिकॉग्निशन चाहिए वो हमें ज़रूर मिलेगी लेकिन फ़र्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हमारी एक कंट्री के लिए ड्यूटी है कि हम अपनी कंट्री के लिए फ़र्स्ट मेडल जीते हैं एंड बिकॉज हमारे कंट्री के जितने भी फैंस हैं वो भी हमसे यही उम्मीद करते हैं एंड हमारी टीम स्पेशली काफ़ी कॉन्फिडेंट है ओलंपिक्स को लेके एंड आई बिलीव हमारी टीम पे कि हमारी टीम अच्छा करेगी ओलंपिक्स में
तैयारी तो ऑलरेडी ज़ोर शोर से चल रही होगी जो चाइना विजिट कैंसिल हो गई है कोरोना वायरस के कारण क्या इससे कोई कंसर्न है टीम में कि आपकी तैयारियों पर असर पड़ेगा
नहीं वो देखो वो हमारे किसी के भी हाथ में नहीं है बिकॉज जो कोरोना वायरस चल रहा है एंड उससे काफ़ी लोगों की लाइफ्स जो हैं वो स्पॉइल होगी एंड दैट्स नॉट गुड बिकॉज लाइफ में अगर सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट कोई चीज़ है वो हेल्थ है हमारे लिए एंड स्पोर्ट्स सेकेंड चीज़ आती है बिकॉज अगर हेल्थ अच्छी होगी देन हम स्पोर्ट्स कर सकते हैं एंड आई थिंक ये गुड डिसीजन है हमारी फेडरेशन का कोचिस का कि हम लोग चाइना में नहीं गए बिकॉज वहाँ इतना ज़्यादा कोरोना वायरस फैला हुआ है एंड लेकिन उसके उसके बाद हमें हमारा जो फिटनेस कैंप अभी चल रहा है इसमें हमें काफ़ी टाइम मिल गया कि हम और काफ़ी सारी चीज़ों पे काम कर सकते हैं जो हमने सोचा था कि शायद हमारे पास इतना टाइम नहीं होगा वो सब चीज़ें करने के लिए लेकिन अच्छी बात है कि हम अब अपने फिटनेस के ऊपर और ज़्यादा काम कर सकते हैं ताकि अभी हमारे कोचेज़ भी प्लान कर रहे हैं कि नेक्स्ट हम वो चाइना की जगह हम और कौन सी अच्छी टीमों के साथ खेल सकते हैं प्रिपेयर करने के लिए अपने आप को.
प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी ने एक शी इंस्पायर्स अस कैंपेन लॉन्च किया जहाँ पे जो उन्होंने कहा कि जो वो विमेन है जिनको जिनसे हमको इंस्पिरेशन मिलता है हमें उनके बारे में बात करनी चाहिए. तो मैं चाहती हूँ कि आप मुझे बताएं ऐसी तीन विमेन शो आपकी ज़िंदगी में हो जिन्होंने आपको इंस्पायर किया.
यस प्राइम मिनिस्टर का आई थिंक काफ़ी अच्छा स्टेप है कि जो उन्होंने बोला कि वो वुमेंस को अपने सोशल अकाउंट्स देंगे एंड यहाँ से पता चलता है कि वो वुमेंस को काफ़ी ज़्यादा कंट्री में अटेंशन पे कर रहे हैं कि वो भी चाहते हैं कि हमारी कंट्री में जो वुमेंस हैं वो अच्छा करें. जैसे मेरे लिए कि इंस्पिरेशन है कि स्पेशली आपके घर से शुरू होता है आपकी मदर होती है जो आपको ऑलवेज इंस्पायर करते हैं कि आप हमेशा यू नो हार्डवर्क करो एंड जैसे अभी हम मैरी कॉम की बात करते हैं कि वो फोर चिल्ड्रंस की मदर हैं एंड स्टिल शी इज़ यू नो एवरी टाइम उसके अंदर वही हंगर है खेलने के लिए जीतने के लिए कंट्री के लिए. सो वो काफ़ी ज़्यादा एक इंस्पिरेशनल वुमेन है मेरे लिए जो हमेशा इंस्पायर करते हैं एंड द सेकंड थिंग जो हमारी टीम है काफ़ी यंग एंड यू नो मिक्सचर टीम एक्सपीरियंस प्लेयर्स हैं दे आर द बिगेस्ट इंस्पिरेशन फॉर मी कि जिनसे मैं एवरी डे कुछ ना कुछ सीखती हूँ ज़रूर.
तो अगर आपको प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी का सोशल मीडिया अकाउंट दे दिया जाता एक दिन के लिए तो आप कैसे यूज़ करती है आपका क्या मैसेज होता पूरी दुनिया की वुमेन के लिए जो आप हु फॉलो यू एंड लुक अप टू यू.
मैं उसको जस्ट ऐसे ही आई थिंक वैसे तो मैं नहीं करना चाहती बिकॉज मेरे पास इतना टाइम नहीं होता बट अगर हाँ हुआ तो मैं डेफिनेटली सबको यही मैसेज देना चाहूँगी कि आप वुमेंस में ज़्यादा बिलीव करो एंड स्पेशली मैं वुमेंस को बोलना चाहती हूँ कि सबसे पहले वुमेंस खुद में खुद बिलीव करना स्टार्ट करें तभी वुमेंस में कोई और बिलीव करेगा. जब तक हम खुद बिलीव नहीं करेंगे कोई और हमारे अंदर कभी बिलीव नहीं करेगा एंड आई थिंक डैट्स बिगेस्ट थिंग कि हमें हमेशा जो हमारे ड्रीम्स हैं हमेशा बिग रखने चाहिए और उसके लिए वैसे ही हमें काम करना चाहिए. कभी भी छोटी छोटी चीज़ के लिए हमें लाइफ में कंप्रोमाइज़ नहीं करना चाहिए बिकॉज समटाइम्स हम गिव अप कर देते हैं एंड डैट्स अ ईजी थिंग. गिव अप करना बहुत ईजी थिंग है लाइफ में लेकिन नीचे गिर के उठना वो डिफ़िकल्ट थिंग है जिसके लिए सभी आपको यू नो आप में बिलीव करना शुरू करते हैं एंड डैट्स द माई मैसेज फॉर द वुमेंस.
रानी ऐसा कोई मोमेंट आपकी लाइफ में आया जब आपको लगा दैट यू वांट टू कम्प्लीटली गिव अप पर फिर आपने अपने आप को पुश किया और कहा कि नहीं नहीं रुक सकते एंड उसके बाद आपने फिर मुड़ के पीछे कभी नहीं देखा.
आई थिंक 2006 में जब मैं जूनियर कैंप में आई थी तो उस टाइम मैंने स्क्वैट किया वेट के साथ एंड उस टाइम मेरा खुद का बॉडी वेट 36 केजी था एंड 80 केजी के साथ स्क्वैट किया तो वो वेट मेरे ऊपर गिर गया था जिसके कारण मुझे बहुत बैडली बैक इंजरी हो गई थी एंड देन वन ईयर मैं बिल्कुल बेड रेस्ट पे थी. देन मुझे लगा कि शायद मैं लाइफ में कभी हॉकी नहीं खेल सकती दोबारा एंड बट डैट वॉज़ द टर्निंग पॉइंट कि मुझे लगा कि नहीं लाइफ में गिव अप नहीं करना लेकिन अगर आप गिव अप कर दोगे तो देन आपके ड्रीम्स ही रह जाते हैं सिर्फ. डैट्स द मोमेंट कि मैंने गिव अप नहीं किया लाइफ में.
वेल आई एम ग्लैड मुझे बहुत खुशी है कि उस टाइम आपने गिव अप नहीं किया और आप यहाँ तक पहुँची और आपने हमारे कंट्री के लिए इतना अच्छा खेला है. वी आर ऑल वेरी प्राउड ऑफ यू रानी रामपाल. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस. The conversation about bringing about a change continues and I believe it shouldn't be a conversation that we simply have on March 8th every year. It should be a conversation we should be having every day. We should be celebrating women and their achievements in every walk of life, every single day, even for our average women. And we should be talking about giving them a level playing field. And pay parity is actually one of those ways to do it. If you pay them equally, you will see more and more women come out care of their own families. and excel in every single field where men are actually excelling. It only starts off by acknowledging that men and women are the same. Thank you so much for joining us.